Hey everybody, just saw one of my former classmates ride by. He's just driving the bus. Oh, Mr. Delonte. How's everybody doing? I'm here in my hometown of Columbus, Mississippi. Getting my first look at the damage that was caused by the tornado that came through Saturday. It's tough. It's tough to look at because this is a area, a neighborhood, and a street that, you know, I'm very familiar with. As a matter of fact, I was right here on this street Saturday, hours before the tornado hit. And I want to show you guys some of the damage. What you're looking at right now, that is my old middle school. That's Hunt Middle School. I went to seventh grade here, and it's tough to look at it right now, to look at the damage that was done to my old school. The roof gone, most of the roof gone. You see parts of the building left. I just talked to a couple of my classmates. One of them's back down there helping direct traffic. Just talked to a couple of my classmates, and they told me that they're hearing that they're going to tear the school down. And that's sad because, you know, this is a historically black area. I think Hunt was a, I think it was a historically black school, if I'm not mistaken. And then it became the middle school and the intermediate school. And recently it has been changed and designated to a sort of a museum, but I think they also still have classes. Yeah, just the seventh grade, because in eighth grade, we all moved to Columbus Middle School, because what Columbus High School, it was two different campuses, two different buildings. That was Columbus High School East, Columbus High School West. Then they added on to the Columbus High School East, and all the students who went to Columbus High School West went to Columbus High School East. And then that is when the kids who were going to seventh grade here, instead of staying here for seventh grade, we went to the new old/new Columbus Middle School, which was at the old high school, if that makes any sense. So that's why I was only here at this particular school for 1 year. But, you know, it was a fun year. As a matter of fact, I'm looking right now in that little classroom right there. That used to be where we used to go to have our, back there behind me, you can see kind of right there. That used to be the classroom. I'm not sure what that means. I was just talking about the neighborhood. But that used to be the classroom where we used to have art class, because I remember walking through that little corridor right there to get to my art room. And so, you know, it's just sad to see what has happened to my old middle school. And as you can see, they've already done a lot of cleaning up here in the area. And as a matter of fact, my stepdad has a house right back there. He still owns that house. You know, I remember going there a lot before he and my mom got married, and you know, spending some time over there. So, you know, this neighborhood I'm very familiar with. And I know, you know, some people saw yesterday or Saturday me post a picture about the community center where generations of my family were hours before this storm hit. Now this part is tough, because I want to show you guys what I'm looking at right now. This part is tough because Saturday we had my grandmother's funeral. And after the funeral and after the burial, we had my grandmother's repast. And this is the building that we had the repast in. Like, the pictures don't do it justice, honestly. And I'm looking at this building, and I'm looking at the way that this roof has collapsed in. And all I can think about is generations of my family could have still been in this building had we not left an hour beforehand. I mean, this is tough. Because so many of us were in there. And when I say
generations of my family, me, my mom, my aunties, my uncles, little cousins. I mean, it's, as a matter of fact, I'm gonna pull up a picture on my other phone to show you all what I'm talking about here. So, I don't know if you can see it. This photo right here, that photo of my brother and my three sisters, that photo was taken Saturday.
Right beyond those steps, right in front of that wall. And I mean,
it's tough. Because if God wasn't looking over us, we could have still been in that building. And again, the pictures don't do it justice. And I can still see, I mean, we cleaned up everything before we got out of here, but I can still kind of see some of the tables in the back. I mean, the roof is just collapsed in, and that really could have really done really been devastating for the Hunter and Miller family. But again, I'm gonna show you guys some more stuff in just a second, and then I'm gonna get over here and, you know, see what I can do to help out the cleanup efforts.
But again, this is the middle school that I used to attend, and this is the community center. It's so funny. I was talking about, you know, I was telling my daughter like stories about this school like that day, because we were right by it, right next door. And so I was telling her stories about, you know, running through those halls. We had pods, the investigators, the alligators, some weird name for our pods, to like separate, you know, all the kids into like groups and things like that.
I think I was in the investigator pod. And you can see it's two buildings. The back building seems to have some damage, but not nearly as much as the front building. But again, we are hearing that they are going to tear down the school, which is sad. And it's going to be sad to see it go. Because here recently, in the past few years, there has really been an effort to revitalize this area. And that is why you see this center here. The Boys and Girls Club used to be over here, but you see this community center they built here. And again, this was an effort to try to, you know, revitalize the neighborhood. All right, and I'm going to show you guys Sim Scott Park.
Has a baseball field there. Baseball field obviously has some damage. Basketball courts, you see a lot of debris and damage. The pavilion, oh wow, that's the pavilion over there. I just noticed the pavilion, the roof has completely fallen down on that pavilion. Thankfully nobody may have been inside it, that pavilion, when all that happened. The basketball courts and goals are over there. As a matter of fact, one of my good friends stays right on the other side of that pavilion roof. Looks like their house was not severely damaged in the storm, but I mean, literally right on the other side of where that pavilion roof has collapsed is where one of my good friends stays, you know, a guy that I grew up with, and, you know, still see on a regular basis when I come home. And the interesting thing is, what's happening here is that the community has come together.
And I've already seen several community groups out barbecuing, cooking, handing out food for those who've lost everything. Because some folks have lost everything. Each year, there's a big event that happens here in this little park right here. I'm gonna show you the
park.
Like there's a big event that happens here every year in this park.
I can't remember the name of it. It might be called the Sim Scott Day or something like that. And as a matter of fact, I was here last year. I came to the event last year, and you can see where the
scoreboard that was once standing there, because this used to be a baseball field until they moved it over there. And you can still see the courts and the goals right there. But you can see here where the sign for keep score has fallen down, and the light pole as well has fallen. And you can see some of the damage from the trees. And again, some more damage to another part of that Simscott Community Center. But every time I look at this building right here, that community center, man, I think about the fact that so many generations of my family were in that building just an hour before all of this happened. You can kind of see in the background, got some folks over here barbecuing and, you know, doing things, doing whatever they can to help out those in the community. And I know that, as a matter of fact, like I was saying when I first came on, just finished talking to a couple of classmates, Ashley and Tiffany. We all went to We went to that middle school together. We graduated high school together. And, you know, this is an area that has so many memories for me and so many people here in Columbus. And it just puts perspective on it. The interesting thing about it, though, is, you know, Columbus has been hit by several tornadoes over the past 20 years. Like, I can remember at least three tornadoes in the past 20 years. One that happened maybe in 2003, 2004. It destroyed a large section of the south side of town and knocked down several buildings at the MUW, Mississippi University for Women. As a matter of fact, the building where I graduated from was just destroyed by that tornado maybe about 15 years ago. And homes and, you know, the neighborhood that I grew up in, where my grandmother lived, her house barely escaped getting hit by the tornado. But like a few blocks over, two or three blocks over, a lot of houses were destroyed. Families had to move. And to have this happen roughly 15 years later and on the north side of town, I mean, it's just, you know, it's just devastating to see. And to see this happening in your hometown where you grew up, a place that you called home, and a place that you called home. Because, you know, I come to Columbus all the time. Like I said, I was here Saturday when the storm hit. You know, a lot of my friends always, you know, they make fun of me because they know that, you know, how often I come home. They're like, why do you go to Columbus so much? It's my home, you know, it's where my family is. I like to see my family and be around them. So I do that a lot. And I'm in this area a lot, seeing some friends. As a matter of fact, my cousin Caleb, who's a star basketball player for New Hope High School, which is in Lowndes County, used to play basketball right there a lot. The goals are still up, but I mean, you can see the area. It's not what it used to be. I mean, and this is the roof to the pavilion that I was just talking about. And you know, thankfully, you know, obviously, you know, when the rain, the storm comes through, everybody should get inside. Thankfully, nobody was still here under the pavilion when the storm hit. Because, I mean, look at what happened. The roof, it just came down. Looks like it just blew on over. I mean, look at how strong that storm is. It literally picked the slats out of the ground, out of the cement, and picked them up and moved them and pushed them over and knocked down the roof. As you can see, they've already been doing some cleanup. Some trees have already been cut. A lot of people in the community have already gotten together and done whatever they could to, up to this point, to try to clean up the area. But I mean, you know, again, for me, just walking around right here, it's heartbreaking. That's all I can say. So you can see just how far that the roof of that pavilion was pushed over. I mean, you know, it started there, and you see the slats right here, the beams pushed over, and yeah, the entire roof just fell.
going on?
What's up?
Not much. Doing good? Doing all right? Y'all over here getting the power back on?
Not yet.
Man, it's tough.
Tough to see.
Yeah, now it's all the middle school, man. It's tough. Yeah. It's gone. Oh, yeah.
It's going to look different.
Yeah, it's going to look different. You know, like I was just telling the folks on Facebook Live, you know, it happened maybe 15 years ago on Southside, and, you know, it got back together. So.
Man, I had just got out of college, man.
I was just getting into college when it happened, so I know all about that one, man.
Right.
So, yeah, that was tough. I'm going to let y'all get to it, man.
Okay.
All right. Good to see you, bro.
You too.
All right, again, you know, like I told you guys, you know, this is my home. This is where I'm from. So, I mean, you know, during this Facebook Live, it's not going to be uncommon that I'm going to run into some people that I grew up with, run into some people that I went to high school with. You know, it's crazy. It's, you know, we report on the news all the time, and, you know, when it happens and it you know, when you're reporting and then it hit close to home, it gives you a better sense of what others are going through when something like this happens. Because, you know, again, you know, we've been through this before, but it's always tough when you see it firsthand for yourself. Because I remember I was working at WCBI here in Columbus when that last tornado hit, and we were out before the sun came up. And when the sun came up and I saw, you know, my neighborhood, parts that I, as a kid, walked up and down the street often, you know, I saw it was decimated. You know, it brought a tear to my eye then. Because, you know, these are places that you know, people that you know, who you know have lost everything. And so that's difficult. But you know, like what happened several years ago with the tornado on Southside, yeah, you know, Columbus, you know, we're gonna rebuild. This is our home, and we've done it before. We've rebuilt before, and we're gonna rebuild again. So we will rebuild. But again, I'm gonna switch the camera around to show you guys some more of what we're seeing. And again, this is like from the other side of Simscott Park.
You can already see over here, again, like I was saying, the community has already come together. You have folks who are already, you know, handing out water, food, snacks.
Yo, what's going on?
Right, how you doing?
I'm good.
Right.
Good to see you.
Definitely run into some folks
that I know that I grew up with. And you see over here, you know, people handing out clothes, handing out bottles of water, chips, drinks, you know, whatever they can to, you know, help those who are affected by this. Because, you know, this is a close-knit community. A lot of these folks have lived here their entire lives. And so, you know.
My makeshift.
Okay, councilman, you want to say anything to the folks on Facebook Live?
Well, my makeshift community center, where we giving back to the community, making sure that people that don't have lights get a chance to eat. You know, cut down trees yesterday. We've been cutting over there earlier today. So we just trying to do our part and make sure that we take care of our community.
Now, you grew up in this neighborhood.
Yes, sir. I grew up right there, actually.
You grew up right there?
Yeah.
You know, when you see this, when you see what happened, you know, just kind of talk about what your first thought when you saw the aftermath.
Devastating, man. I tell you, you know, from growing up over here, and, you know, we have our Easter egg hunt over here, you know, every spring. We have a Halloween thing over here. It's just devastating, you know, seeing all the destruction, you know. But, you know, we thankful that, you know, we didn't have a lot of loss of lives. You know, I think maybe one or maybe two, they may have found somebody else today, I heard. But, you know, it could have been a whole lot worse, you know. So, but we definitely blessed.
Talk about real quick, and I'll let you go. I know you're busy. The middle school over there. Just seeing the middle school. Do you know if they're gonna just tear it down? Has there been any talk about that yet?
I don't think they'll tear it down because of the historical, point of it. Mm-hmm. So I don't think they'll tear it down. But I hadn't heard anything. But I'm pretty sure they'll come in and try to fix it up. Because they actually have the African American Museum, local museum over there.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm thinking they'll come and fix it. I know EMCC was getting ready to actually do some classes over there.
Oh, wow.
They were actually fixing that part up for them.
Oh, wow.
And so I'm pretty sure that they'll fix it up.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's good to know, because I was telling the folks here on the Facebook Live just about the historical reference of that school.
Right.
What that school means to the community here in Columbus and in this area.
Right.
And it'll be tough to see it go.
It was definitely an African-American high school before it became middle school, we all went there. I'm pretty sure you went
there.
Yeah. So, but I'm thinking they'll fix it up though. Right.
All right. So appreciate that.
All right. Thanks. All right. Good to see you, man.
You too.
All right.
All right. That was us. What's going on? That was Columbus City Councilman Stephen Jones. He grew up right here, in the house behind me. And you see, he's already over here.
Set up a makeshift little community area for folks to come and get some supplies if they need them. And as he was saying,
there was a museum that was there in Hunt. And so it was the local African American museum that was there in Hunt. And like he was saying, the plan as of right now is to, or he thinks the plan is to not to tear the building down. I've heard some folks saying they were going to, but hopefully they don't, because the historical reference and the historic point of that building makes it so that it definitely would be nice to not have that building torn down. And the fact that EMCC was getting ready to start doing some classes over there, because I had read that those buildings that were destroyed were classrooms, so I guess they were the classrooms that were just starting to go up there at EMCC that they were getting ready to start having there in that building. So this is a neighborhood
that I kind of grew up in. My grandmother it was on MLK, which is
you go back behind the school and turn left, it's right down the street. My stepdad
had a house right behind the school that I used to frequent and be at a lot. So
looking at this, is it's bad right now, but one thing we do know is that the city of Columbus will come together, and that
we'll get this fixed.
We had that tornado that happened here a few years ago, maybe 15 years ago.
We got it fixed, and that one may have, may have even been worse. So the
good thing is we know that this is a community, this is a city that knows how to come together in the wake of destruction. And it will. And everybody's gonna, get together and pull through.
So I'm gonna walk back over here to where
the community center is and where the high school is. Before I end this Facebook Live, you can see right there some trees and stuff are torn down. Now, this is not the only area that's been devastated by the tornado. It was a tornado that seemed to have jumped. That means, comes down, goes back up, comes down. This is one of the areas where it was down. I've seen pictures from as far away as Lemberg Road, which is, maybe a few miles away from here, that have damage, but like areas in between, maybe a few blocks over in Lemberg, are not damaged. So it just kind of goes to show you that how these storms work, what happens when these storms come through. They don't take a certain path. They don't care what's in its way. They'll go up, they'll go down, and you want to be in a safe place when that happens.
And as you can see right here, you can see some of those poles leaning over. This goes to show you just how powerful the winds were. You can see that scoreboard lifted out of the ground.
another example of how powerful the winds were. And again, the community center and Hunt, right there. Community center where at least, and I'm not making this up, folks, at least four generations of my family were inside that community center an hour before the storm hit. We're celebrating my grandmother's life at her repast at that community center an hour before the storm hit. I know some folks who were watching earlier
are not watching, and some folks who are
I just wanted to show you guys this picture real quick again.
Show you guys this picture again for reference.
That's my brother, my three sisters, and I
standing in front of Sim Scott Community Center.
Those are my three sisters by themselves, standing right there in front of the community center. And about an hour after that photo was taken, that happened. And, you know, I don't know what you can say other than God, looking over our family. I don't know what more you can say than that.
Because right there, that brick wall that's no longer there,
that's the wall we're standing in front of.
That wall, no longer there.
See that sign? The Sim Scott Community Center sign? See that sign right there in that picture? You see that door?
I mean,
just looking at it just gives me chills, honestly. Just an hour. 1 hour.
1 hour between that photo.
Definitely his close to home. Very close. And again, my old middle school. And hopefully they don't tear down the building. Hopefully they rebuild.
Because it's a great school, has a lot of history behind it.
And Columbus will be back. Do you know that? But anyway,
thank you all for checking out this Facebook Live. I appreciate it. And we'll have much more coming up on the news. I know Scott Simmons was up here earlier today doing some stuff. And so we're going to have a full report on 16 WAPT News. Oh, wow. And look, I want to just show you guys
how good God is. See this school, and you see this home right next door to it.
This home doesn't seem to have much damage at all. See the women from above living in the house, right next door to the school. One empty building, another building that became empty.
An hour before the storm hit. Did lose some life.
One that we know of right now, for sure. It could have been much worse.
But again, I want to thank everybody for checking out the Facebook Live.
And make sure you watch 16 WAPT News tonight at 6 and 10 for much more on the aftermath of the tornado here in my hometown,
of Columbus, Mississippi. All right, everybody, thanks so much for joining us and checking us out.